One of the biggest biotech gatherings kicked off today in Washington. A key question on the agenda, how to speed medical discoveries to patients. Bloomberg's healthcare correspondent Shannon Pettypiece is live from the Bioinnovation Conference with a special guest. Shannon?
Thanks, Mark. I'm here with Francis Collins. He's the director of the NIH and was also part of led the Human Genome Project. And Dr. Collins, you've expressed frustration that more hasn't been done with your Human Genome Project. Why do you feel that is?
Well, I think everyone is anxious to see the incredible deluge of molecular discoveries about disease get translated into prevention and diagnostics and therapeutics. But that is a long, slow, failure-prone pipeline. And depending on who you ask, it takes on the average 15 years to go from the discovery of a possible target for a new drug to actually getting that through the pipeline and approved, and 98% of the time it fails along the way. That doesn't seem like the kind of system that we would hope to have at this time of such great opportunities with so many insights about the causes of disease in front of us.
And now, as the director of the NIH, you're trying to do something to change that. What are some specific things you're trying to do to speed this process along?
So we're starting a new organizational structure at NIH called the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences. This will bring together into one organizational unit the expertise that we think will help with re-engineering the process, looking at this pipeline for therapeutic development the way an engineer would, saying, why do we do this step in this fashion? For instance, why do we do the testing of compounds to see if they're safe in humans the way we do them? We put them through various animals and we try to see if there's any evidence of harm done to the liver or the heart or the kidneys. Those systems are tried, they're not always true. They don't necessarily give us what we need to know. Now that we have all of these abilities to manipulate human cells with embryonic stem cells and making three-dimensional organoids that look like human tissues, shouldn't we try that as an alternative that would be faster and potentially more accurate than what we currently do? That's just one example. I could name you 10 or 12 of these places where we could improve on the process in a way that would speed it up and would reduce the failure rate.
Now, all that takes funding, though, and in a world of belt tightening around Washington, how's the outlook for the NIH budget?
The NIH budget is in a terrible squeeze. We are, of course, part of the discretionary budget, and everybody is focused, as they should be, on this dreadful deficit that we're facing. And so we are in a circumstance where it's harder to do new innovative things, but I don't think we should stop trying to do innovation just because things are tight. We have to do less of some other things in order to do the new ones. I am concerned, though, that the average investigator who comes to NIH now has only about one chance in six of getting supported, and that is quite demoralizing, particularly for our younger generation of scientists who are revved up about the ability to make a contribution. NIH is a phenomenal contributor to advances, but it's not always been recognized by support.
But we've kind of relied on big pharma to do most of this innovation. You feel like they've let us down here and the government needs to step in now? Is that what you're saying?
I think we have a chance for a new paradigm. And I think big pharma would agree with that, and so would biotech. I think everybody's recognizing science has moved on here. We have a chance to come up with a model where academics and the government and biotech and pharma are working in a more synergistic fashion, building on the strengths of each one, instead of having sort of a firewall in between. We actually have the chance with this new paradigm to go faster and to have more successes. But it isn't going to happen without a bit of a rearrangement of the mentality of each of those organizations. I think that's happening, and it's actually a very exciting time.
Well, so kind of breaking down that bridge between NIH and pharma, bringing that together. Well, Dr. Collins, we're going to have to leave it there, but thank you so much for joining me. And Mark, now I'm going to send it back to you.
Shannon Pettypiece, Dr. Francis Collins at the Bioinnovation Conference in Washington. Thanks.